got an update on Dylan?
Yeah, Dylan's ready to go. Great week of practice.
How important was it to determine a quarterback early in the week, especially given you're integrating a new play caller?
We got reps to all the guys. Heinrich's ready to go. I think Heinrich's had a really good 2 weeks, and I think they both have practiced well. Danny's practiced well, so I think we'll take four quarterbacks out there, but I think they're all comfortable with what we do.
When you watch USC's defense, what stands out about what they do and the challenges they're going to present Saturday?
Well, I mean, they're as talented a team and roster as there is. They've got 6'3" corners. they've got length, power. They can rush the passer. They'll play man, overload the box, take away the run, and force you to throw. Throw the ball against big, long guys who are tremendously talented. So, Coach Lynn's done a really nice job there, and we're gonna have to play our best.
What different elements does USC's quarterback bring to their offense?
Well, I think anytime you play against Coach Riley, one of the great, great offensive masterminds in football, you have to first stop the run. Woody Marks, I think, is one of the best backs I've seen in a long time. Tremendous run system that they have, and then they've added in, both with Miller and I'm sure with Jaden as well, added in the ability to pull the ball and run what amounts to triple option. So they're running power and counter gap type schemes to one side and pulling the ball, and quarterback can run it or throw to a guy who's on the perimeter. So very akin to when they had Jalen Hurts when we competed against him at Oklahoma. We went back and I watched the quarterback at UNLV did a lot of the same things in that go-go offense there, triple option type plays. Throws an elite deep ball. He's a really, really talented player. There's a reason why everybody wanted him when we went in the portal last year, and he's getting his opportunity. I thought Miller Moss played exceptionally well as well. So, Coach Riley's he's the best that there is in my mind.
Hey, Coach, now that you've had a few practices to kind of sit back and see him at work, how has the players and Dana kind of done with all this?
I think Dana's just stepped right in. Like I said, it's still the same language. He's, adapting to everything that we do. The players, like I said, it's the same thing. It's just, someone new in the mix. All the same coaches are coaching their guys. So it's just, a fresh perspective on what we were doing. And I think he's gotten along well with the players. And I think the players have practiced well this week.
Is he working with any specific position group, or is it more big picture?
He has a history with receivers. He's coached with receivers for a long time. He has a history with quarterbacks, but those guys are coaching their positions, and he's kind of running the unit and game planning and going in and running different parts of practice, and might sit in a different meeting every day, but he's not attached to any one position right now.
Does he prefer to be in the box, on the field?
Obviously he's called a lot of games, and the games he called as a head coach, obviously he was always on the field. Probably nowadays, with the new play sheet, new words, it'd be easier to be in the box. I think he's still working through all that. I think we have a decision, but I don't want to say it in case he changes his mind. Because that's never bothered me. I've always felt like wherever someone feels most comfortable, it's at the end of the day, it's the play call that matters the most. But I wouldn't be surprised to see him on the field, and I wouldn't be surprised to see him in the box. We're still working through a little of that.
Stay upstairs and we'll
be down. They're tops in the country in net punting. When you look at their special teams, what do you see, and how has this bye week been useful for you in that phase of the game?
Yeah, I think they've got great athletes, and their athletes enjoy playing special teams. You watch them in all the phases. Their return game. I went to the Jet Awards last year, and obviously Branch won the Jet Award. He's explosive and dynamic, a factor. We kind of, after that Rutgers game, we changed what we did on punt, and made some adjustments. And so every week that we're in it, we're better, you know. And but they provide a tremendous challenge, not just, you know, schematically, but really more the people that they have out there. They got guys who love to play it, and you know, our guys understand that that's going to be a big part of this game and that we have to play well.
Beyond Dylan, any injuries of note going into this one?
No, not really. I think we're pretty healthy.
Matt, what do you think of getting to coach a game inside the Coliseum?
Yeah, I was there as a graduate assistant at UCLA, and UCLA had beaten USC like 5 times in a row, and it was Pete Carroll's first year, and they were, you know, maybe struggling a little bit, and then we went there and they beat us. I think it was the second to last game of the year because of 9/11, and then they were off and running. yeah, I mean, it was a great experience the first time being a head coach there. I mean, it's an iconic place, a lot of history. You know, obviously, with the recent passing, I think Coach Robinson just passed, right? So, I mean, obviously, there's been great coaches, great players. It's the new world of college football, and it's great to be a part of.
Matt, when you usually have a whole offseason to kind of install a offense, play call, all that, like trying to jam that into 2 weeks, just what kind of adjustments does that take on your end to kind of expedite that?
It's really been, for me, just being very flexible in terms of like, hey, coach, what do you need? You know, do you need an extra meeting here? Do you need practice this way? Do you need practice there? It's what I've always liked to do. I've never been very rigid with those things. You know, I always liken it to, you know, if you're a golfer and you're struggling off the tee, you don't want to go take a chipping lesson. You want to work on your driver. And so, to me, it's always being flexible in the process of what we need. And adapting to Dana and kind of what he needs to get ready, but also then, you know, he's obviously adapted to the situation that he's in. But, you know, a lot of credit to him. I mean, he didn't have to do this. You know, he didn't have to step in at this point. But I think he sees the challenge in it. He also sees the opportunity. And same thing for us. Obviously, it's a little bit of a challenge, but I see a tremendous opportunity here. And I have to be flexible. He has to be flexible. And it's been fun, to be quite honest with you. It's been a great week, really 2 weeks, just to make this thing work. So, you know, we'll go out there on Saturday, we'll play. What I'm very sure of is that we'll get better every single day. I think it's a really good setup right now.
Are there elements of his integration that have been smoother than you thought? I mean, a lot of talk about the challenges. Are there some things that have just been really smooth?
I think the whole thing's been smooth. I think the whole thing's been seamless. And I think the way Sat, Glenn, Garrett, Donnie, EJ, the way that they've made it seamless, you know, because they've, hey, this is that, and they've just adapted to it right away. And so I think everyone's excited about this opportunity. Everyone's excited to have someone of, you know, Dana's resume in the building. And so yeah, it's been way smoother than maybe one would think. But I wouldn't have done it if I didn't know Dana, know his ability to do something like this. And so, I think it's been good. And we'll go play Saturday and see if there's any hiccups in the process. We'll adjust them moving forward. That's why, like I said, like this wasn't some short-term splash thing. This was to me an opportunity to make an epic move that can push us into the next tier. This is our first game on that push.
All right. Thanks.